Greetings, my fellow humans. Welcome to The Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild. And today, this thing, I want to talk about the Switch. I want to talk about The Legend of Zelda. And we're going to do it over Gumply of Zelda, because it's the only game I have at the moment. So let's get into the spoopiness. So it's weird because Zelda saves kind of like an Elder Scrolls game. Yeah, it's kind of interesting. There's just a bunch of autosaves and one manual save whenever you want to do it. And I think it overwrites all the time. So I guess we'll just go into this. And the reason I find it weird is because I was expecting this to play like, well, save and load like any other Zelda game where you have like three saves or something and you could choose between them. But apparently it doesn't do that anymore. So, welcome to the Shrine of Resurrection. Anyone that's seen the trailer would probably remember this room. This is the room where Link wakes up and things happen. Oh hey, it's Garak. Okay. Bye-bye. So, that's the thing that happens. So, I have gotten to just after leaving the Great Plateau. And it surprised me because the Great Plateau is pretty big, actually. It's bigger than I initially thought it was going to be. Here's a thing. This was shown off in an E3 demo. How did you can do that. Let's leave ice here. So, that's interesting. So here is the Great Plateau. Well, part of the Great Plateau. The plateau goes all the way over to that blue beacon over there. Right over there, right in front of Link. This, it goes like all the way around. It's this giant rim. And it surprised me how big this place is because it isn't just this place in the Temple of Time. I mean, it goes behind as well. And there's quite a lot to really explore right, in this starting area on its own. The old man's gone. He has given me this paraglider. That's kind of how you get it. My apologies if that was classed as a spoiler. I don't know how it can be, but sure. We're not going to really venture that far into the game. I kind of just want to venture around this area and talk about some things. I don't really want to leave the Great Plateau because there's a... I don't know. I haven't really gotten that far into the game myself, so I think I've played for about 2 hours, maybe a bit more. I don't know. When I play these games, I usually just wander around, so it takes me a long time to really get anywhere. But anyway, so I guess the first thing I want to talk about is the Switch itself. It kind of surprised me about like the Joy-Cons because they're kind of pretty comfortable in a weird way because they're pretty much just a flat rectangle of plastic with notches at the end, kind of like a 3DS, but there's no counterweight at the top, so the weight is all on the Joy-Cons, and there's no like grip or anything on the Joy-Cons to really hold on to. So in that respect, it does kind of feel a bit weird. I haven't seen anyone else really complain about this. Here's some frame rate. That was interesting. That hasn't happened before. But I haven't noticed anyone else really complain about this, but the shoulder LNR buttons, for some reason, I kind of expect them to press in further than they do, but they don't. I'm just putting it down to the fact that I've been playing with the PS4 controller so much. So travel on the LNR1 buttons kind of are a lot further than the Joy-Con LNR buttons. I keep pressing the wrong buttons, and I'm also putting that down to using the Xbox PS4 controller that much. This is a big old place around here. It's pretty big. You know what, let's try to get these guys. Sneak around. Try hiding these bushes, see if he can see us. I think he... Wait, no, okay, that's... Thanks. Wait, do they know where I am? Okay, yeah, they know where I am. Well, let's just switch to another thing. Why do I have like 3 woodcutter's axes? Okay, I need to get like a sword or something. Hello. Dear friends. Oh, jeez. So that's kind of how combat works. I'm pretty bad at it. I'll take this Bako club, because I don't really have anything else. Oh, I already have one. Never mind. I'm terrible at inventory keeping. Don't mind me. So yeah, the Switch feels fine. The weight is okay. I don't really have a complaint with the weight of the Switch. It's slightly more heavier than the 3DS XL, the new 3DS XL. More so, because I think it weighs more than the normal 3DS XL. Only slightly. I don't know. I think there's more stuff in the new 3DS XL, so I guess it would weigh more. I don't know. Please don't quote me on that. If you do, then don't shout at me, please. But yeah, the weight's fine. I haven't really had any problems with the weight. I played with the Switch for about half an hour until I was finally deciding to put it on charge. I don't know what these frame drops are, because I haven't had these before until now. Maybe I've broken something. I don't know. I don't remember breaking anything. I should probably take that guy out again. Let's go over here and then we can get that chest. Hopefully nothing else breaks. Oh yeah, and you just heard some music then. That's because every now and again, the music starts to kick in. I think it's in time with the, well, relating to what time it is. Come on. No. Get him. Thanks. But yeah, the music triggers every now and again. And, hey. It does things. Due to the fact that the music's so minimalistic, it's very nice to hear it chime in every now and again, because I usually just play with music off anyway. So even like Skyrim or anything like that. Sorry, I usually just turn the music off because I don't know. I usually just play with music off because I don't know. I feel like there's more of an atmosphere if there's no music playing. I don't need those things. And if I'm on PC, then I usually play with my music playing as well, so I don't know. I'm not really too bothered with the lack of music. It just makes it sound really nice when there's no music and then music suddenly kicks in. And frame rate. The reason I'm bringing up frame rate so much is because it hasn't been this bad until now. I'm kind of interested as to why and what really caused it. But is there anything else to really say about the Switch apart from everything that everyone else has already said? I didn't unbox it. I was thinking about unboxing it. I even said I might unbox it. Nice. Come on. In the face. Got him. Let's probably take out this guy. Then we can get a chest. Come on, turn. Oh. Okay. The UI is really, really fast. Whoa, hey. Why am I just using this? Please, come on. Got him. Hey. Nice. So, yeah. When you go to the menu of the Switch and when you go back into games, very quick, very fast and snappy. There is a slight pause when you press it in-game to get to the Switch's menu. But it's not much of a problem, to be totally honest. I don't know, it hasn't really bothered me in any sort of way. There's not a whole lot going on the Switch at the moment. Like, as of this recording. Oh yeah, and it's Switchmas. It's still Switchmas. Happy Switchmas.
Yay.
So in terms of like, oh, it's a bug. There you go. But in terms of the Switch, like eShop and Virtual Console, pretty much non-existent. There's some games lurking on the Switch's eShop, but not a whole lot. I would have more games to show, maybe, if there were more games to play. I'm still thinking of getting Bomberman. I think I mentioned before I have like £5 off, so I can just buy it and get like £5 off the game, so that's fine. I don't mind paying less for Bomberman. Whoa. Good job. Okay. Let's try that again. It's weird with the Joy-Cons because they have I guess accelerometers in them. I think that's what I'm trying to think of. The accelerometers. Ooh, hey, ice arrows. Nice. So when you play a 3DS game, you can tilt the controls and, you know, you can move it around, do whatever with, which is kind of nice because it makes aiming a bit more accurate than it would with the analog sticks. Speaking of the analog sticks, there's really not much travel distance on them. There's not a lot of push to them, if that makes sense. You can't really push them a whole distance. A lot, I guess. Yeah, I don't know. But you can't really do a whole lot with them because, yeah, they don't do a lot. You can kind of push them a bit, but not much further than that. I don't know. Sideways chest. I'm trying to think of what else I kind of... Oh yeah, the whole disconnecting Joy-Con controller thing. I haven't had that happen once at all so far. I should probably eat something because I'm going to die. Otherwise, I think I have cooked food. But, yeah, I haven't had Joy-Cons disconnect whatsoever. I think it's the left one, or is it the right one? One of the Joy-Cons, I haven't had them disconnect whatsoever, so, I think I'm fine on that front. Then again, I haven't really traveled more than, like, a meter or so away from the Switch with the Joy-Cons, so, you know what, let's just try it now. I'm gonna... Bye! Bye! I'm like, I don't know, I'm a distance away. Everything still seems fine. I've turned the Joy-Cons inside out. Joy-Cons behind my back. I don't know. I'm not having any issue with it. The Joy-Cons seem fine. I've got them behind my back. I have them in the Joy-Con grip. They're fine. I don't know what the real issue. Oh hey, there's thunder soon apparently. But I don't know what the whole issue is with the Joy-Cons. I'm guessing they must have patched it or something because I haven't had any issues with the Joy-Cons whatsoever. Could just be the press release versions of the Switch. Who knows? Maybe it could have just been a software issue with the Switch that they patched on day one. Who knows? Nobody knows. But I haven't had any issue with the Switch. I just put it behind my back. I did a bunch of things with it, and I didn't have any issues at all. I was moving around, moving camera, it was fine. Maybe, like I said, could have just patched it. Could have just done that. Nobody knows. Oh, hey, a chest. Hey, chest. What did you do that for? This is what I mean. I keep pushing the wrong buttons, expecting them to do the wrong thing. I keep pressing B, expecting it to do A's job. it's a fun old time. Can I get that back out? Hey. No? Oh yeah, and there's this really nice little thing that I haven't really seen done before. It's a really minute touch, but I fucking love it anyway. And it just adds a whole new, like, level of depth to the world that I absolutely love and adore. So, just as an example, I was wandering around off of the plateau, and I found this guy in the trees, and he was Deathsike living there, and he was a, I think he was a traveling merchant or something, and I went to talk to him and sold some things, and I didn't buy anything because I didn't have anything to really buy from him, and I saw an axe on a stump, so I went up and took the axe that was on a stump, and he was like, hey, that's mine. And then he was just like, oh, but, you know, it was probably my fault anyway for just leaving it there. So, it made me kind of feel guilty for taking this guy's axe, which is weird because I haven't had that happen before. When I've taken something, because when you play a game, you just go up and take someone's stuff. You don't really have any, like, thought about it. You just take the stuff and leave. And no one really says anything, whatever. You just go out on your merry way. But that's such a small touch. It made me feel so guilty for some reason for just taking this guy's axe. There's a really interesting thing that I want to show in a second. So, let's just get rid of this guy first before he does that. Okay. So, here's a Bokoblin arm. Let's have a look at that. Let's just move in. It's just a moving Bokoblin arm on the floor. Don't worry about it. There's really small touches like that about this game that I really like. When you get to, like, cold areas and you go into menu, Link's shaking. That's a really nice little touch that I kind of liked. I haven't learned anything new in terms of, like, cooking or anything. It's all kind of just food I pick up off the floor that I eat. There's, I think there's, like, effects that happen when you cook food with other food. I don't know. I think that's how it works. I didn't really pay much attention to mechanics trailers or anything. I just watched the original, well, some of the trailers and some gameplay trailers and things, and it's pretty much all I really watched. I don't really care about learning more about the story because I wanted to do that on my own. Wee. Oh, hey. Let's go over here. Oh, hey, lizard! Ah! There you go. Okay. Well, that happened. Is that a pitchfork? You can take a pitchfork. Okay. But going back to the Switch. Oh, hey. He left a thing. Ooh. Nice. I might actually wear that. Cool. That's pretty cool, actually. But yeah, going back to the Switch, I don't know if there's really much else I really want to talk about in specific to the Switch. I've pretty much just said all I really want to with the lack of games. Everyone's complained about the lack of games. The eShop's pretty much empty at the moment. Haven't had any issues with the Joy-Cons. They seem fine. Wait, the Switch itself is fine. I don't really have any problems with that. Can I cut this down and take it? Ooh, I can. Wow. This thunder is pretty awesome as well. But straight away, when I first started the Switch, it was insane that I was playing something like this and I could just take it anywhere. It's just crazy to think about for some reason. Pop. There's a chest. Whoa. What? What a... I broke something. I'm all staticky. What? But, I think... Whoa. I think one of the main problems everyone has with the Switch is, everyone's just kind of just asking where this will go in terms of how Wii U went. Holy crap, that was close. Because the Wii U just died pretty much instantly. Some fantastic games on the Switch. The Wii U. I'm talking about the Wii U now. What is this? But there's some really great games on the Wii U. Whoa! Holy crap! Oh my god! Whoa! That happened. So yeah, we're back here again. So yeah, some really great games on the Wii U. It's a shame that Nintendo's kind of just dropped support almost instantly after having it for about 4 years. This seems like a problem. This seems like a huge problem. Ah! I don't know. I'm just gonna hold on to this. Oh, okay. Fair enough. That makes sense. That was scary. No, don't do it again. But yeah, there's some great games on the Wii U. If anyone tells you there's no games on the Wii U, it's good for nothing, don't buy it. Just don't listen to them. Mmm. Don't listen to them. There's some great games on the Wii U. If you want to buy it now, then buy it now, because Zelda's on the Wii U. You can do that. It's fantastic. The reason I bought a Switch is because I want to support Nintendo, and what I want them to make a fantastic system that can just be supported for a long time. I don't want what happened to the Wii U happen to the Switch. And I think that's a really big problem, and what everyone kind of sees happening to the Switch. It's kind of like, oh, the Wii U died. Not even after, well, not even into six, its sixth year, and everyone's just expecting the same to happen to the Wii U, the Switch. It's kind of sad. I don't want it to die really, really quick. I want it to do things, and I want Nintendo to be able to do things with it. Because this is a really neat little console, and I was almost instantly like blown away when I started playing it. It's just a great little system. And something else I want to bring up is the temperature. The temperature is fine. Like, it really doesn't get that hot. After playing it for about 2 hours with the Joy-Con grip in my hands, it was fine. I didn't really have any issue with the Joy-Cons, the console even. The console really didn't heat up at all. Well, for me it didn't. It was fine. When it's in the dock, you can hear the fans kind of spin up because it's doing a lot more processing stuff, which is kind of understandable. But yeah, I'm fine with the system. I'm completely happy with my purchase, to be totally honest. I don't really have any issues with it. Assuming Nintendo holds up and does things with the Switch, well, I kind of don't want it to just die, I guess. I want Nintendo to keep doing things with this console, and I don't want them to just drop it. Everyone's saying, well, all the quote-unquote haters, I don't know, everyone's entitled to their own opinion, but the people that consider haters, that are considered haters, I guess, are just saying, like, oh, the Switch is gonna die, whatever. So give it a bloody chance. If you don't give it a chance, it's not going to survive, that's the thing. So you need to give it a chance. I don't know. Nintendo's starting to show signs that they want to start coming into the modern market, I guess. And it's kind of shown with the Switch, but I don't know. I really like the Switch, and I want Nintendo to keep supporting it, I guess. I don't know. Zelda's pretty gosh darn good. From what I've played, super, super great game. I don't know how it really compares to the Wii U version, because I don't have the Wii U version. I only bought the Switch version because, you know, I wanted to support the Switch, I guess. I don't know. People could take that out of context and be like, you bought a Switch, you wasted money, shut up. But I wanted to buy the Switch because it's a whole new console. I wanted to be part of the thing that's like, Nintendo, we kind of want you to do this. I'm kind of just really rambling at this point. Can I try and get onto this? Where does this go anywhere? Let's see if I can... Nope, that was the wrong button. Nope. Trying to use a magnet on a wooden boat. Raft thing. Nope, that's the wrong thing again. But if I can, I would like to talk about Zelda for a bit. Whoa! I don't think that was supposed to have happened, but sure. This game is really, really good. I think it was worth the wait. I've broken that boat now. I'm gonna leave it alone. But yeah, the game's fine. I really enjoy it. It honestly did kind of make me a bit worried when reviewers started coming out with like 9s and 10s for no reason. The reason I say that is because really weird example, but with Fallout 4, when that game came out and someone had an opinion that was like, this game isn't like this 10 out of 10 game. It's okay, but it's, well, it's a good game, but it's not worth a 10 out of 10. I guess the review was saying that. I have no idea what the guy's name was. It was ages ago. But I think that's pretty much what you're saying. Like, it's not a 10 out of 10 game. It's like 7 out of 10 or something. Game scores are stupid. I don't care about game scores, but that was just something I remember because everyone got up his ass pretty much, and that happened. But yeah, that was something that happened. And when this came out of like all round 10s, I was kind of worried that people are blinded by this being a Zelda game that we've been waiting for like 3 years for. I don't know. It's a weird thing, but I was worried that people were going to start freaking out, be like, oh, it's a brand new Zelda game, blah, 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 and not give it a fair review. Where, again, I'm someone that doesn't really see it as a 10 out of 10 game, but it is still a really, really good game that I still feel like you should play, even if it's on the Wii U version. It's just a really good game, pretty much. I don't think people should really focus so much on game scores. It's dumb. What I really like about the game so far is that you're pretty much just given items straight away. You're given the sword straight away. You're given, I guess, armor, clothes, things straight away. That's interesting. You're given, like, bows and arrows pretty much instantly, which I'm a huge, like, supporter of because I think it's kind of stupid when you don't get bows and arrows straight away in an adventure game. I don't know. I always just found that stupid, but it's nice that you get those things like straight away. You don't have to work hard to get these things for the Sheikah Slate. You get the bombs pretty much straight away again. All this stuff, I don't know how this is going to work into the rest of the game. I'd be interested to see how that kind of works. I tried getting to Ganon straight away, if anyone's interested. I tried getting there. I got killed by Guardian. I got stuck there. I had to reload an earlier save because I kept getting killed by Guardians. That was interesting. So yeah, I haven't been able to fight Ganon yet without barely touching this story. Again, literally only just got off the Great Plateau, so not really that far into the story. So yeah, again, the only thing I can really say about Zelda is it's a great Zelda game. It's really new, interesting where the Zelda's going into. Going back to basics, I guess. Pretty much is. Just going back to NES Zelda. Zelda 1 and Zelda 2. It's a bit more linear, I guess. I would say Breath of the Wild is a lot closer to Zelda 1 than Zelda 2. Or any other Zelda game. This really is the closest that Zelda's been to NES Zelda 1 for quite some time, so. Also, people comparing us to Ocarina? I don't know. For me, for some reason, I've just compared it to Wind Waker. I don't know why. I just see a comparison to Wind Waker for some reason. I don't know if anyone else does, but it just seems very Wind Waker-esque to me. More like the art style and stuff. But I don't know. I don't know what anyone else really thinks about Zelda. I haven't watched reviews. I don't know. I haven't read reviews. I haven't looked any further than this game's a 10 out of 10. I just know that this game is really, really good, and I really enjoy it. If you want to play it, and you've been waiting for someone to say, play it, then play it, because this game's good. Yeah, if you don't, here's the thing. At the moment, the Switch isn't really worth the money, at the moment. I would really recommend just waiting until the price goes down, or until, like, later in a year or something. Just don't buy into the Switch yet. I think the Switch at the moment was more for, okay, I don't know what you do about that, but I think the Switch at the moment is more for just a huge fans of Nintendo, really. There's not a whole huge reason to really buy the Switch apart from what I've said. Oh, look. Here's a thing for a thumbnail. B- But yeah, because of what I said with like the lack of game support and whatever at the moment. I know there's a lot more games coming soon, but at the moment there's just not enough to really suggest getting a Switch at this price. Just wait until more games come out, I guess. There's barely any games on the virtual console. No, there's no games on the virtual console because it doesn't exist. Barely any games on the eShop, like I mentioned. There's barely any games at all at the moment, which is obvious because that's what everyone's really been saying from the start. If you want to buy Switch, it's up to you, I guess. As a like critic, I guess, with an incredibly loose thousands number of quotations, I'd consider myself as a very basic critic. I critique things on a very basic level, but on a serious note, if you want to buy a Switch, buy a Switch. But don't expect to have a whole ton to do straight away. It still feels like the Switch is in development, I guess. Yeah, there's a long way for the Switch to go before it really picks up momentum. And that obviously really shows at the moment, but I think you'll get there eventually. I really do think the Switch is going to pick up momentum. People are going to find out about the Switch and find out what the Switch is about, I guess. Not to sound corny or anything, but yeah, I really do think the Switch is going to pick up momentum eventually, but don't buy the Switch at the moment. I really don't think it's really worth buying at the moment if you want to buy a new console. Yeah, if you have a Wii U and you want to play Zelda, get it on a Wii U. That's all I can really say. So, yeah. I don't think there's really much else to really talk about in this, so thank you very much for watching. I don't think there's anything else to really cover. Until next time, I'm gonna float down here and hopefully I don't die. Ooh. Slight offside thing. Here's a stable. I just found a stable. This is a guy on a horse. There's people. Hello, person. Something goes off. Okay. NPCs are actually doing things. There's a kid. Kill him. I spooked the horse. Donkey. It's a danky. What are you doing? Yes, what are you doing? No, I'm fine. So, again, thank you for watching, and until next time, goodbye.